Movement along the same demand curve is of two types. First movement is upward movement along the same demand curve, and second is downward movement of the same demand curve. First, we will discuss the upward movement along the same demand curve. If there is upward movement along the same demand curve, then we can say that there is contraction. In the condition of upward movement, there will be contraction in demand. How can we say that the demand will contract? First, we should understand this with change in its own price. This condition can be happened, or the only reason behind the upward movement or the contraction is demand, that is the change in its own price. If the price of the commodity rises, only in that condition the quantity demanded falls, and this is called the contraction in demand. Remember this thing: if the price of own commodity, if the price of commodity X rises, then quantity demanded for X falls. Okay, and this is called the contraction in demand, and we can say demand contracts. Here, the other factors which may affect the demand or determinants of the demand, that factors should remain constant. Okay, all those factors which may affect the demand remaining constant, these factors are like income, price of related goods, taste, fashion, preference of the consumer for that particular commodity. It also remains same, no change in taste, fashion preference and other things, and no change in price of related goods. Related goods are of two types, so no change in complementary good, no change in price of substitute good, and no change in income, money income of the consumer, no change in the future expectation even. If there is any kind of change in the availability of that commodity and the consumer expect that the availability of that commodity will be changed, so we assume that all these things remains constant. Even supply of that particular commodity also remains constant, and other availability of substitute goods also constant. So all these factors which may affect the particular commodity's demand, we consider them as constant or as same. By taking these factors constant, if price of X, we assume that initial price P0, initial price is 2 rupees per unit, and the another price which is in if there is rise in the price and price becomes 4 rupees per unit, in that condition the quantity demanded will fall. At 2 rupees per unit price, consumer was demanding 10 units, and if price increased or price rise, in that condition consumer demanded less units for X, and demand falls from 10 to 5 units. Okay, at 2 rupees per unit, quantity demanded is 10 units. At 4 rupees per unit, quantity demanded is 5 units. And for this particular table, I have made a graph. On y-axis, we have taken price of X. On x-axis, there is quantity demanded. This is 2 rupees price, 4 rupees price, quantity 5 and 10. Okay, first we will plot initial price and initial quantity. Initial price is 2 rupees and initial quantity is 10 units. So 2 rupees and 10 units, first point will be here at A. Second point, the price is 4 and quantity is 5. So second point is on B. By adjoining these points, we will get the graph, demand curve, and at this curve we can easily understand that after rising the price, consumer moves from A to B. And after this movement, after the upward movement in the demand curve, the demand, quantity demanded contracts from 10 to 5. Earlier, consumer demanded for 10 units. Now, consumer demands for 5 units. So, we can say there is contraction in the demand for a particular commodity by a consumer. Okay? And which is the important thing here? The important thing is that the contraction may occur because only of change in its own price. If there is change in own price of a commodity, then there may be contraction or extension. But when contraction will arise, the contraction will be there if the price of the own price of the commodity will rise. Rise in price creates fall in demand, and this is called contraction. But there is a condition, and that condition is other factors, other things remaining constant. And these other things are income of consumer, money income of consumer, then price of related goods. Related goods are price of complementary good and substitute goods, and taste, fashion preference, expectations, future expectation for the commodity, availability and other things, supply of the commodity, and substitution, other substitutes, availability of substitute goods. All these factors should be constant, and if price rises, only then quantity demand falls. This is called contraction in the demand. Next is backward movement along the same demand curve. Earlier we have discussed upward movement along the same demand curve, and upward movement shows the contraction in the demand. Just opposite is here. If there is backward movement along the same demand curve, if consumer is moving backward along the same demand curve, it means there will be extension or expansion in the demand. Okay, it means we can define this term as if there is fall in price. If there is fall in own price of a commodity, then quantity demanded for the commodity rises. This is called expansion or extension in the demand. But here few things are remaining constant, like other factors, all those other factors which may affect the demand, or those factors which are determinants for the demand, just like income of a consumer, monetary income of a consumer, price of related goods, expectations for the availability of that commodity, taste, fashion and preference for the particular commodity by consumer, and other availability of substitute goods. All these factors remaining same. Only in that condition, if all these factors remain same and the price falls, and the price falls, I assumed that earlier the price was 4 rupees per unit, and now price falls by 2 rupees and it is 2 rupees per unit now. Okay, so at 4 rupees the quantity demanded is 5 units, and at 2 rupees quantity demanded rises and it is 10 units. Backward movement shows the extension. Here the price of commodity and quantity demanded. Price earlier it is 4. I assumed that the price is 4 rupees per unit. At 4 rupees price the quantity demanded is 5. If the price falls and became 2 rupees per unit, in that condition the quantity demanded will be rises. It will rise, and the new quantity demand is 10 units. At 4 quantity demand is 5, at 2 rupees quantity demand is 10 units. Okay, I made the graph. First point I have plotted for 4 rupees and 5 units. 4 rupees on y-axis and 5 units on x-axis. 4 and 5, this is point A. Second point is for 2 for 10 units. Price 2 rupees for 10 units. 2 rupees here and 10 units. Okay, so we get 2 points A and B. By adjoining both these points, we will get the demand curve and the movement of a consumer. This is point A and this is B. By adjoining these points, we can easily observe that consumer is moving from A to B. Here, consumer is moving downward. That's why it is called downward movement. Okay? Along the same demand curve. Ek hi demand curve ke upar consumer A se B tak aa raha hai. Toh yahan A se B par aane par, the consumer's demand is rising from 5 to 10. That's why it is called extension of demand and expansion of demand.